Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Rohan campaign. I believe it's episode 44, where we are. We're going to try. I'm fairly confident we are going to try and succeed in destroying Adunafel's invasion army, because it's mostly, you know, cheap orc looters as well as, well, ranged orc looters and orc looters, which are light infantry, which are prey for our cavalry. So we've got Durngar the Honorable here, who is going to attack from the flank, and for some reason, I imagine, like, this, for some reason, Durngar, to me, he strikes me as a man who is powered by the sun. Like, his hair is, his golden locks act like solar panels, okay? So as the solar rays hit his head, they begin to glow and shimmer because he is the Solar Knight. And you know what? It kind of reminds me of, like, Bulbasaur. In the old Pokemon anime, you know, he'd gather sunlight in his bulb and then shoot it using solar beam. Solar. Okay, so we're going to attack Adunafel with our 240 cavalrymen, as well as the 1,500 infantry that Captain Osford has within the garrison, and I guess there's not much for it. We ought to just hop in on the battlefield, although I am kind of trembling a bit, because this is in fact a large army, and if we play poorly, we could very easily cripple both of our armies, because as we all know, the Rohirrim are not good on foot. Anyway, I'll see you guys on the battle map. All right, here we are outside of Isengard, apparently. Nowhere to be seen, of course. What we do have, though, is a road that fucking just leads to nowhere. What in the goddamn world is that about? You know what? In some ways, this is what this makes me think. Okay, you're just going along this cobblestone road, and then all of a sudden you come to the end. Because it just, of course, ends in the middle of nowhere, and the next thing you know, a bright light descends from the sky, and holy shit, you've just been abducted. You've been abducted in the middle of nowhere. You're in an X-Files episode. Scully is skeptical, even though she has literally seen you get pulled into the sky. She's still like, well, there must be some logical explanation for this, but there never is, Scully. She just refuses to change her mind, or at least accept that things are not always as they seem. Okay, we are going to shove our men into this formation like so, make sure they're not skirmishing. Okay, now I have accidentally, oh god, I've put all of my cavalry at the extreme end of the battlefield, which is not terribly helpful. I want to bring, oh god, like, even here, it looks even worse here. Like, he's just washed out in white. Oh god, he's powered right up. That's what's going on. Okay, I want to bring the riders to the front, because I hope to kind of blunt the blade before it arrives to attack my infantry, and we're going to get the horse archers here, and we're going to have them fire at what the fuck? These are Numenoreans or what? Jesus Christ, they look so stupid. At first, I was intimidated, but then I saw that they had what looks to be literal axe blades attached to their heads. It doesn't look cool in any way. I think what happened is they saw the Knights of Dolomroth and they got really jealous. Like, man, they have cool wings. And Sauron was like, what? Well, yeah, they have cool wings, but so do you. And he just threw whatever he had onto the old helmets there. Okay, we're firing at the Dol Guldur host, which is not what we want, but oh, we are actually hitting Camul's Shadow Knights, which is definitely peculiar. Oh no, We've aggroed some archers. Let's flee. It's interesting that Kumul's men are on the battlefield here, considering that this is actually a Dunafell. I don't really know what the logic is there. Okay, so we've got some enemies advancing towards our lines. We are firing at some Mirkwood hunters. We've got orc looters. Okay, we just, yeah, get around the flank. That ought to be fine. And let's find those archers. Okay, they're fleeing. We'll get the horse archers back to shoot Kamul's dudes in the rear. Let's just get these guys off to the side for now. Okay, the Solar Knight is moving in. We're firing at these ranged orc looters, and it's pretty ineffective, to be honest. So maybe we'll switch it up. Start firing at these lightly armored orc looters. Okay, so we've got our general here, who can probably very easily crush some of these units. We'll get the light cavalry in place. Perhaps they can chase off those archers. Speaking of archers, we still have this unit here. Yeah, I don't know. We'll just keep our cavalry in motion. And here we go. We're going to charge these orc looters in the flank. Hopefully we can just kind of sneak bow. What the fuck? What is this? Give me a goddamn break. Oh my god. You can't just stay in a line for one goddamn minute. Oh god. If your mother were here, she would be fucking livid. Okay, we did in fact charge those orc looters in the rear, and we killed quite a few of them, but not nearly... Oh god, we're getting fired upon. Oh no, no, it's just we have run straight into a group of orc looters. Maybe we can pull our men out of there, hopefully. Okay, we'll get the general out. We'll get these riders around the flank as well. Now our horse archers are doing pretty well. Let's just... It looks to me like they're being run off, though. Perhaps? I don't know. Regardless, we're getting them up the hill because, I don't know, just it will be easier that way. And we are actually losing Riders of Rohan. Yes, indeed. My archers are, for some reason, skirmishing. Let's just pull them back. Fuck it. Oh, no! What is this? Oh, God. Kamul's Shadow Knights have charged straight into my spear line, which is disconcerting, to say the least. That just shows that he has no fear. No fear at all. Okay, so we have actually flanked around. We've got some orc raiders here, which we will... maybe we can sandwich them between these two units. We'll draw them off with the light cav, okay? Alright, let's set up a line here. We need these infantrymen around the flank. I really want to box in the general, if at all possible. What's going on here? We have been charged. Okay, that's not ideal, to be honest. Alrighty, let's see. We've got these guys again around the flank. We're going to have to work to... Oh, shit. Here comes Kamul's assholes. Oh, you idiots. What are you doing? They've become engaged. And not in a good way. They are not getting married. I wish they were, because that would be good tidings, but unfortunately in this instance, it's actually a situation where bad things are happening. And here comes Kamul again. Let's countercharge. Oh no, we're gonna lose a ton of fucking axemen here. Oh god. Oh no! Ooh, that really... Oof, ouch. That really fucking... burns my butt, I tell you what. Okay, well at the very least we can countercharge them and kind of take what is owed. We've got some axemen here, which I don't even know what to do. Maybe we'll come around the flank like so. Oh my god, we are losing so many infantrymen. Fuck. Oh, I am not at all pleased about that. And the worst part about it is Kamul's Shadow Knights are standing tall. There's still, like, oh god, 60 of them. Or 30 of them, I should say. Motherfuck, and my riders are not doing well at all. Oh my god, like, they're hardly... Oh, fuck me, they are not dying. Okay, we're gonna chase off the enemy archers. We're gonna come around the flank, try to scare them off. What do we got? We charged here. Where's our general? He's fled. Let's get that unit taken care of. And we have just charged the enemy archers. Excellent. We'll still fire into that mass. Why the fuck not? Oh, that is heavy infantry. Let us avoid that garbage. Okay, our general has... He's beginning to deal with some of these men. Not doing so hot. But there we go. We've now flanked the enemy infantry. Let's envelop them further. It should not... Oh, fuck. I totally forgot about my horse archers. Oh, no. God damn it. They have been woefully ineffective this battle. Where's my second unit? Actually, let's wedge him. Wedge him? I don't even know what I'm trying to say. I just need to scare off these enemy archers lest they hit my men in the rear. But holy shit, we're actually doing quite well with the counter fire here. The Shadow Knights, though, have really cut through. Weirdly enough, they've just totally destroyed my axemen. Who would have thought? I guess I should have tasked the spearmen with that job to begin with, but I did not. Let's roll up the line here and see if we can scare some of these archers into our cavalry unit. But holy shit, our archers are getting fucked by these Uruk blades, and I need them to get off the field. And we are still in combat here. I think we took this unit out, though. What do we got? Yeah, that unit is gone. We need to strengthen our flank again. Actually, you know what we'll do? We'll rebuild the combat line. We'll pull these spears out so that they can aid with the cavalry. And holy shit, what are we tied up in here? We got some ranged orc looters, and it's just ranged orc looters. Okay, let's get the rest of the cavalry here. We got some orc maulers we need to deal with. Well, we don't have any arrows left, unfortunately. We'll have to dedicate the old cavalry, I think. Actually, I don't know. Maybe I'm gonna use the axemen to maybe draw them out, and then we can just rear charge. Okay. No. Fucking Kamul is going after my other unit of... Oh, fuck me gently. This is... What the fuck is this? Okay, I gotta pause this just to evaluate. Okay, we have some archers fighting some orc looters. Kamul has just fucking chewed through two of my units, and that actually pisses me off a huge amount because they're fucking relentless. I have nothing really to counter them. Okay, I gotta get my general out of this situation. We are going to... I don't know, continue this assault, turn around, attack those orc looters. Maybe we can break them and then go for these guys. Actually, you know what we'll do? We'll get the old Solar Knight. I almost said Shadow Knight, but actually, that's my fucking nemesis. We'll get the Solar Knight out. Hopefully he can lead a charge, a successful charge, that will ruin our foes behind the lines. Come on, you guys. Oh, don't walk. Oh my god. Okay, we have just sandwiched these orc looters in the center. They're wavering. These guys are shaken, and they've been charged in the rear, and they've broken. Excellent. Let's get the general again. And have we broken that unit in the center? We have not yet done so, but we still have to... Well, first of all, avoid that Dulgul Dur host. But then we have to chase off these dickheads. Okay, so we actually have been charged in the rear by those Maulers, which is not ideal, but at the very least we can charge the Maulers in the rear with our heavy cavalry. Here it comes. Shazam. There are only 80, 70, 60 Oh shit, we did actually lose a horseman though. We killed 30 Maulers, but they stand tall. Ah, it's just my fucking luck that they're resilient. Okay, we're slowly swarming oh, come on, you assholes. Slowly swarming these looters. Okay, let's just sick all of the spearmen on these dickheads and get all of our infantry involved in the center. Okay, here we go. We are going to charge this last unit of looters. It seems that there's still a few missile units in the center of the field, which we can continue to just charge down with our riders. Fairly certain this is going to break that heavy infantry. They are broken. These light infantry, there's only 16, 15 of them. Okay, they've both broken. Excellent. Let's see. Kumul's Shadow Knight. Oh, God. There's still 24 of them, and they are in and amongst our spearmen. Arguably the only unit in our army that is actually designed to counter that cavalry, but I believe, I get the feeling that the Solar Knight is the true antidote here. Sunlight is the only disinfectant, the true disinfectant, or however that fucking, the best disinfectant, you know, that old chestnut. Okay, so we have actually sacrificed many Riders of Rohan on this day, but we have yet to win said day. We're going to have to use our general to, first of all, run down this goblin infantry very quickly, then this other unit very quickly. Okay, we're still only 18 minutes into the episode. Oh, fuck, what is this? Okay, that's my Riders of Rohan. I was very concerned for a moment. I thought maybe, just maybe, it was Kumul coming around the flank in order to ruin my archers, who for some reason did not retreat when I could have sworn I told them to. Now, let's see, we're just gonna strengthen. What in the fuck are you assholes doing? Are you kidding me right now? I tell them to retreat and then they run towards the most powerful unit, the most frightening unit in the enemy army. Unbelievable. Okay, we need the general to deal with these dull, the Shadow Knight assholes. And we'll use our light cavalry to run down all of these brews who are just, you know, they just happen to be fleeing at the moment. And oh my fucking god, really? Still. Even still, these archers insist, I tell you, on running to their doom. Let's see, one unit has somehow made it around, but the other, good lord. Okay, we are finally making headway against these Shadow Knights. Let's get around the rear. Okay, classic maneuver where you get around the rear and you poke your nemesis right in the behind. Oh man, I love it. Okay, we finally we're doing some damage, but what in the fuck is this? My Riders of Rohan are trying to run down orc looters, but somehow, even still, they manage to lose men. Oh, I see, there's a Dull Guldur host here with 5 infantrymen in it. Give me a fucking break. I don't believe it. Okay, well, we'll have to counter their infantry with my remaining infantry. And here come the Riders of Rohan. Boom. From 17 down. Okay, it seems to be effective. Okay, we did manage to kill some. Okay, well, that's certainly disappointing, considering that we ourselves lost, like, 4 cavalrymen in that charge. Good God. Okay, there we go. The riders and the infantry have truly taken care of that Dol Guldur host. They treated them to a candlelight dinner. Maybe a bit of a movie. They took them to see The Last Jedi, because we all know how much the hosts of Dol Guldur really enjoy a good Star Wars film. You know, this holiday season. This is not a sponsored video, by the by. Okay, well, we'll try... Well, here we go. Let's actually set up a proper charge. That may have been good, but you never... You never know. Oh my fucking god. Kamul and his dreaded Shadow Knights have somehow managed to pull through all of my massed infantry. I don't fucking believe it. Oh, good god, that ju- That rattles my cage, it surely does. I'm at a loss for words. I really don't even know what to say about this situation. The five of them remaining have sprung out the other side, and they're just sauntering along, fun and fancy free. But I have to say, despite the pain in my ass that is Kamul's Shadow Knights, I do get a solid chubular out of this line of orcish bodies. And then, of course, you see the 300 or so Rohirrim that got chopped asunder, torn asunder by Kamul and his Shadow Knights. We're going to have to absorb this charge. Hopefully we can do some damage with the light cav, but I doubt it. Oh, we did in fact kill one of them, and we lagged to such a degree I thought the game crashed. Okay, we killed two of them. If we can hold them in place long enough for... Ooh, it's... Oh my god, it's just a Dunafell now. It always comes down to this. Fuck me. Oh god, okay, well, at the very least, we want the general to get a good charge off. Is it gonna happen? Yep. And it's ineffectual. Wow. Wow, I just love this. Okay. Did we... That's all it took? We just broke him just then? Can we at least capture him or kill him or any number of things? Yes, no, maybe so. Oh, God. There it is. Whew. Oh, Nelly Furtado. Okay. Praise the Lord, we have actually destroyed the invasion army at quite a large cost. 30% of our entire army has fallen. Though, to be fair, that is not a price I am unwilling to pay. Okay, let's head back out to the campaign map. I believe we have time for one more turn. Well, I have to tell you, I'm pretty pleased. We actually managed to execute... We executed a Dunafell. And Durngar the Honorable has received all sorts of shit. A shield bearer as well as an orcish blade. Okay, that's excellent. No, that is not at all what I meant to do. But, it's not a problem. Okay. For the time being, we are going to stash our cav in the fort, so we're not paying for them. And we may as well spend a bit of dough to retrain... some of our units, the weakest. Actually, a better idea. Let's just merge everything and then retrain. And we can possibly purchase and recruit some new units if at all necessary. Alright, I believe that's... Oh shit, I completely forgot about this. Okay, well, I'm just gonna ignore this and hope that they don't assault the walls this turn. Cross your fingers. Okay, it seems Harith is betrothed to Wuskfree, which is a name that sounds familiar, and the portrait is very familiar as well. I'm just going to pretend that is not a problem. Oh, motherfucker, we have finally won the invasion. And they've called it off. Excellent. Okay, that's interesting. So now I suppose... Your orders. Can we, Okay, I think now we are forced to... Holy shit. Okay, first of all, I think we're forced now to sue for peace with all of these enemies that we've accrued... Mostly because we want to get into the good graces of the dwarves of Erdluin, who seem reticent to get an alliance, probably because we're at war with half of the known world. I don't blame them, to be honest. So we'll try that in a moment. But first of all, I just want to point out that Dolomroth is actually occupied by rebels. I remember joking about it, but no, full on. There was some sort of military coup, and I guess maybe it was a peasant uprising? I don't know. Dolomroth has been occupied by some other force. Some force other than the traditional nobility of Dolomroth, who swears no fealty to the kings of Gondor. Very bizarre. Okay, let us speak with the tribes, the Haradrim tribes, rather, and we will ask for a ceasefire. And they're just not into it at all. Very interesting, okay. Alright, so we have a new general in Edoras.
Yes, my lord.
And he is respected. So I suppose that he ought to be some sort of governor. And we currently are missing one in...
Your orders, my lord.
We are currently missing one in Durwath, Gineard, Gind... and Alkford. I think we'll send him to Alkford because it is one of our most profitable settlements, I believe. Well, so is Isengard. Isengard does not have a governor. Okay, well, that's a shorter trip and it is worth more, so we'll send the 16-year-old Whiskfree. He is going to act... he's going to be the representative of the king in Isengard for the time being. Motherfucker, that's crazy. And hopefully he trusts his advisors. Hopefully he grows into a kind and capable leader. For the time being, we are actually going to try to recruit... some more cavalry. I believe... let's see. Rittermark heavy cavalry. Am I unable to recruit them as is? It seems so. Okay, I very much want to build this knight stables. It is 3,600 gold. That is basically our entire treasury at the moment, but it's... that's what we're doing. Because I really want some new types of cav. Some not light cav, essentially. That would be ideal. But anyway, eventually I want to recruit more cavalry because we do have these forts around our kingdom and just an absolute fuck ton of them. So I see no reason to leave them empty. We could potentially have all sorts of, like, fast response teams, you know, just groups of cav strewn about. And then whenever some mischief arises, we can just, you know... call the riders, etc., etc., as I've mentioned many times before. Okay,
my lord.
Swidhelm the Kind is looking to attack Dunlarach, which is actually a little bit more powerful than I had anticipated. There is basically a third of a stack within, and then, you know, two-thirds without, so I see no reason... I think we can win this battle, but I would much rather have cavalry to do it. Let's see.
You are weaker than I.
We have a scout here. Let's take a gander.
First, I will take your lands.
I believe it won't be a problem. I don't know. We'll besiege the place and build a bunch of equipment just in preparation. There is a chance that they counterattack, and then we'll be in some trouble. But for the time being, we're just going to... take a look at Beret Vin, where we have Aldwulf and Eomer. And should be able to hold out for another turn, actually. Okay. It seems to me that they're going to counterattack next turn, so... yeah, mostly light infantry, a couple pike units. So we'll want archers. a couple units of spears. Okay, let's pull the fourth spearman out. We need another three slots. And I'll pull these axe units out as well. There we go. I just want to put Aomer into this stack because, you know, this cavalry will prove invaluable if and when the Enidwythians try to sally out. Now, in the old quest, not much is going on. We're going to have to deal with that another time when we have some gold. But we're still just, you know, building our armies, so on and so forth. All right, everyone, I'm actually going to end it here because this episode is getting a little long. When we come back, we will probably be dealing with the battle for Baradvin with Chieftain Fuska, the faction heir, sallying out and attempting to puncture through our lines, and I suppose ride for Dunlarach and get some help. Possibly Austin Edel or Byrig, which we will be capturing pretty shortly, I imagine. Anyway, thank you, everyone, for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you all later.